Hi and hello everyone, to all of you connected right now, those in the online and those present dito po sa loob ng simbahan sa labas, I welcome you in the Diocesan Shrine of Jesus the Divine Word. We are in Christ the King Mission Seminary, Quezon City, Philippines. Our topic for today is Journey and Encounter. Kasi this is inspired by Jesus Himself. Jesus is going to Jerusalem and He passed by a village along Galilee and He encountered the 10 lepers. Napili ko itong journey and encounter because yung buhay mismo natin is a journey and this life is full of encounters. Pero pinapaala sa atin, whether you encounter Jesus or Jesus encounter you, your life, when you go to your destination, will never be the same again. Just like the 10 lepers, after encountering Jesus, they were cleansed. So believe in me. Take courage. Be hopeful. When you encounter Jesus, He will make a big change on your life. That's why it's a good reminder to all. Expect that your journey as a family or as a person will never be the same again. It will change for the good. It will change for the better. Applying this to our daily life, allow me to share to you tatlong insights where or how we can encounter Jesus the most in our life, on what significant spots. Una, we can encounter God the most in our journey, especially in our journey of, tatong letter dito, lahat letter T. So first letter T, we encounter God the most in our journey of tears, yung luha. Sabi ni isang theologian, many times God speak the loudest, mas narinig natin siya in our experience of pain, tragedy, and trials. Kaya nga to those of you listening to me right now, when was the last time you cry in tears before God in prayer? Some say the most beautiful prayer they experience and offer to God is they cried in silence and tears falling down their eyes until their tears dried up in their faces. I saw that here in the shrine when I'm passing by going to the office. Many are here silent yet crying. Some say is when you cry before God is the most liberating experience. They felt something release, unloading. By the way, we can cry for many reasons. Out of joy, out of surprise, because life is full of surprises, or out of sadness, or because you are frustrated, or because you are heartbroken, or simply you're in the hospital bed and then told the Lord, take over, then you cry. Pero whatever is making you cry the past days or today, whatever is making you cry, don't stop encountering God in faith and hoping. Tutunga talaga, many situations and trials will really test you, but remain strong. Like the 10 lepers in the journey of Jesus, they crowd out to Jesus and raise their voice, say to Jesus, Lord, have pity on us as a family. Have pity on us. Pangalawa naman po pala, second, we can encounter God the most sa ating paglakbay sa buhay is when we have thankful heart. A thankful heart, the second letter T. Kasi a thankful heart is an open heart. And God appreciate a grateful person. So always remember that. That's why Jesus, when He cleansed the 10 at siyam lang ang dumating, ano sabi ni Jesus? Where are the other nine? Meron po ako sa inyong suggestion. This is doable suggestion, and I will provide you the reason why this is so helpful. Sana, the moment you first open your eyes in the morning, huwag niyo kaagad kunin ang cellphone. The very moment you open the first blink of your eye, as you wake up in the morning, thank God. Kasi sabi ng isang quote na nabasa ko, the alarm clock may help you wake up in the morning, but it's the love and divine plan of God that kept you alive. Kasi may plano pa talaga ang Diyos. Pero St. Thomas Aquinas provided a very simple yet very deep reason. Nabasa ko ito for 6 months reading the Summa Theologica in the middle of the book. Sabi niya, the sound of the chickens and birds chirping could be the reason that you were awakened in the morning. But deep behind it, it's God's goodness that activated you to be alive. Activated. So thank you in the morning. Thank you, Lord. It's also a sign of humility. Ang opposite kasi niyan is pride. Lalo na yung sham na hindi bumalik. Minsan kasi pagtapos na ang problema natin, pag okay na tayo, di na nakakangailangan, di na nakakaalala. So always be humble and always be in need of God. Alam niyo kung bakit? Why we need to always to be humble? Because sabi nito yung St. Thomas Aquinas, we are not always activated. We are not always activated. Itong journey natin is temporary. You never know if you're going to wake up in the morning. Other than that, nakita nyo naman, sometimes we have down moments in life. Na isang araw, I was so sad, I don't know the reason why, I just lie down on my bed for 1 hour. There are down moments. We are not always activated. Kaya nga, all is grace. If ever nakaupo, nakarating pa kayo sa simbahan dito, nakapagbukas ng cellphone, because God's the one who activated you. So be thankful that at very moment you're able to listen to me. It's God who made you, who caused you to do that. God is the reason. So always find a reason to be thankful. There's always a reason to be thankful to God. Kasi a thankful person will always have the eyes to focus. You will see the good and the bad. You will see opportunities in the midst of crisis. You will see because it's grace of God who activates you in every way. Wala pong kailangan ipagyabang. Sa totoo na naman talaga, we are always in a journey. And last po, na letter T, where we can encounter God the most. Last letter T, that will give birth to another letter T. Ano itong last letter T? So whatever and spite of you are undergoing, friends, always trust God. Just in case lumabas na yung resulta ng laboratory mo and the result is not bad, or you try to buhayin yung negosyo this post-pandemic but it's not giving a good return, or your family seems going nowhere, or your marriage, or yung mga anak mo, you want them to have good future but they are not performing well, it adds up to your frustration. But still, trust in spite of everything. There's always a reason to, because only a trusting person will have the capacity to experience turning points. That's the importance of trust. Trust will lead you to turning points in life. Turning points, in other words, bounce back. But do you want to bounce back? Then trust. Do you want turning points in your life to happen? Then trust. Kasi a person who does not anymore trust will be very bitter, will be very angry over the situation, will be very frustrated. Kaya isipin mo na lang, just in case you experience some failures or mistake, at least added lesson, may nadagdag, walang nabawas. Kasi kung if you were very bitter, isipin mo maraming nabawas ng bata ka, you were so deprived, you were so wounded, it will not let you go nowhere, bounce back. So to close his homily, meron pa akong gamitin na symbol. I would like to leave you a, baka corny ito sa inyo ah. I hope ang mga tao pong mahina ang tiwala sa sarili, sa Diyos, sa buhay, sa journey, pag may sitwasyon sa buhay niya, parang pinggan ang sitwasyon. Pag nahulog sa floor, mababasag na, ay dead end na, period na, breaking point ko na, break point na, break broken na, break point. Pero ang taong may malakas na pagtitiwala, trust, ang sitwasyon parang bola na pag nahulog sa floor, uuntol, it will bounce back, it will bounce back. Ibig sabihin, it's not yet the end, it's not breaking point, but a breakthrough. Break na break because it will pass you to another level, a better level. So that's a good motivation for that seminarians, to all of you listening right now, if you're a parent or a businessman trying to recover, or you have sickness, whatever the situation may be right now, it may be very difficult, but bounce back, breakthrough. Allow God to lead you through. So listen to me, trust so that you can bounce back. Believe God can turn around your situation. That's why encounter Him always in your journey. Because when you encounter Jesus, your journey will never be the same. So God bless everyone.